Previous study, we looked at cooling these brains on fire, so to speak, and then in this study, we're looking at essentially stopping the fire from starting or putting it out earlier. So I'm Dr. Richard Gordon. I'm a group leader in translation neuroscience here at UQCCR. Drug repurposing allows us to utilize drugs approved for other conditions, so cancer, hypertension, any other immunological conditions, because Parkinson's disease and many of the brain diseases involve chronic inflammation in the brain, like we've shown in our previous study. If we can repurpose any of these drugs that are approved for other conditions, it allows us to get these drugs to the clinic for Parkinson's disease much faster and at a much cheaper cost. So that's our main focus. So this study, we started to look at mechanisms by which the immune response is activated in the brain. So in the last study, we had a very exciting drug to block this pathway called the inflammasome. So the inflammasome is a protein complex that assembles in Parkinson's disease and drives the progression in brain cell death. So this study is looking at how the inflammasome is activated and what happens in the process of assembly of the inflammasome in the brain. So this study is made possible because of generous donations and donors who contribute to Michael J. Fox Foundation, Shake It Up Australia, and they've been consistent supporters of our work during this entire time, and this research wouldn't be possible without them.